Hello and welcome. I'm Alina. I appreciate the effort you've put in so far, and I'm excited to have you join me as we take the knowledge you've learned so far to build a basic PHP website. In this course, we'll use PHP to make our website easier to maintain by using template files, which will allow us to use the same code and content on multiple pages. We'll also be using PHP to allow visitors to browse through the collection of media and look at the details of a specific item in an easy, customizable, and scalable way. Before starting this course, you should already know a little about how web pages work and be able to write simple HTML and CSS. If you don't, you might want to take a detour and head over to our basic web design course first, which I've linked to in the teacher's notes. While we have already put together the HTML and CSS you'll use in this course, you will be manipulating the HTML with PHP. So a basic understanding will help you keep up with what we're doing. If you find an area that you're struggling with, try reviewing the materials linked in the teacher's notes. If at any time you find yourself stuck on an issue, check out our awesome community forum for support. Now that you're ready to get started, let's take a quick look at the finished site. On the homepage, we have four random selections from our catalog. These random items refresh each time the page is loaded. We also have four links across the top: books, movies, music, and suggest. The first three take you to the specific pages of our catalog corresponding to their headings. Clicking on books takes you to a page listing the books in our catalog, organized alphabetically. From our category pages, there is also a link to the full catalog. This takes you to a page listing all the items in alphabetical order. If you click on an item, you go to the details page for that item. Movies and music work the same way. A catalog of items, you click for details. While this is a fairly basic site, it gives us a good chance to explore some of the most common website aspects. Next, we'll go over the basic setup and organization of our project. The first thing we need is an environment for running our code. The easiest way to follow along with this project is to launch the workspace associated with this video. There should already be some starter HTML and CSS code, as well as some images included in your workspace. We're going to be using workspaces throughout this project, but if you prefer to work locally on your own machine, you can also download the same project files we'll be working with. Check the notes for download links, as well as a link to our workshop that covers installing a local PHP development environment. Let's go into our workspace and check out the organization of the project files. In the root of our project, we will have the files we are using for the individual pages of the site. Right now, all we have is index.html. There are also two folders, CSS for our CSS code and IMG for our image files. Within the image folder is a media folder with the cover images for the books, movies, and music in the library. That covers everything we need to get started. So in the next video, we'll jump into our project.